quick look online later on and found there's not really all that many good videos on boating safety, and none of them actually covered all the topics that small recreational boaters need to know about. The idea with this video is to give those new to boating, and perhaps some of the more experienced boaties like us, a bit of a refresher on the things you need to know and the things you need to pay attention to. We contacted the Rockingham Volunteer Sea Rescue Group and asked them if they would like to get involved and help us with this project. We would like to thank them very much for their kind assistance in making this video. Firstly, check the local marine weather forecast and make sure you know that your boat and your experience are suited to the conditions. Next, go through all your boating gear. Make a list and check off each item each time you go out. Don't assume that everything is where you think it is. Put your eyes on it and check it off the list. Pay special attention to your safety gear and ensure you have the correct items for the trip you need to do. This includes things like approved life jackets for each person on board, anchors, fire extinguisher if required, bailer or pumps, in-date flares, and perhaps marine radio, EPIRB or PLB, personal locator beacon, if you're going to go into offshore waters. Additional things you should think about taking include water, first aid kit, a knife, rope, a torch, a mirror, a basic toolkit, including spark plug remover, and also spare spark plugs for your engine. Make sure that your safety gear is easily accessible. It's recommended that you're able to put on life jackets, access flares, and be able to start a radio call within 30 seconds. Yes, just 30 seconds. You need to practice doing this if you're unsure. Also, make sure that everyone on board knows what to do in an emergency. As skipper, it's your responsibility to show others where the safety gear is located, how to use it, and how to make a distress call if you have a radio. We highly recommend carrying more safety gear than the law requires you to have. You may not be legally required to carry a marine radio, but it's a good thing to have, because with it, you can log on and log off with your local rescue group each time you go out. Also, make sure your fuel isn't too old. Run your engine up and check that it starts and idles correctly before you leave home. Make sure you have enough fuel plus spare fuel in case of an emergency. Wind can come up very quickly and it can drastically increase the fuel consumption, so be prepared for that. Check your trailer over, including tyres, lights and couplings. Ensure all your batteries are charged and are fully operational. Check that electric pumps, sounder and boat lights, if any, are working. You can purchase a marine radio for less than $200. That's very little compared to most of the other gear you're going to be carrying, and it's one of the best safety devices you can take with you. There are two main types of marine radio for recreational boats: 27 MHz, which is the older style, and VHF, which is the newer one. VHF radios are technically better and have longer range than the older 27 MHz. They do, however, require that you have a license in order to operate them. 27 MHz does not require a license. If you have a marine radio, then always do a radio check and log in with the local sea rescue group before you leave the launching area. If you're boating outside areas with signal coverage, then let somebody know where you intend to go and what time you expect to be back. If nobody knows you're in trouble, nobody's going to come looking for you.